Welcome friends to this another lecture, and this lecture is based on sodium nickel chloride battery. Let us see first evolution of sodium nickel batteries. The sodium nickel chloride NaNiCl2 battery was developed in 1985 by Zebra. It means the Zeolite Battery Research Africa project, headed by Dr. John Coetzer at CSIR in Pretoria, South Africa. The technical name for the sodium nickel chloride battery is NaNiCl2 battery. It is also called as zebra cell. Sodium based batteries have a high energy density, long life, and can operate in harsh environment such as temperatures of minus 40 degree centigrade to plus 60 degree centigrade. For these reasons, they can be found in application in energy grid storage, such as storing energy from intermittent energy sources such as wind and solar power. Unlike many batteries, sodium based batteries consist of solid or solid and molten electrolyte with liquid sodium acting as a negative electrode. These batteries are usually constructed in a cylindrical form, encased in a container that acts as a positive electrode. The chemistry is quite simple, with no side reactions and round trip efficiency of up to 85%. The cathode in nickel chloride, while the anode is made up of sodium. The electrolyte is made up of tetrachloroaluminate of sodium, such as NaAlCl4, and is liquid at the operating temperature of the cells in between 270 degree centigrade and 350 degree centigrade. When the battery is being charged, the sodium atoms in the cathode become ions and migrate through the ceramic electrolyte. It is available free electron could flow as a current to an electric load. This process is reversed during the discharge. What are the main advantages of NaNiCl2 batteries? Let us see. No need for air conditioning. High energy density, long cycle life, maintenance free. These are some of the advantages. State of charge and state of health indication, remote monitoring of the system is achieved. Zero emission and high recyclability of raw material. After that, commercialized since the middle of 1990s, sodium nickel chloride batteries have found application in electric vehicles and hybrid electric vehicle, buses, trucks and vans. No toxic or dangerous materials are used during the manufacture of sodium nickel chloride batteries. The battery is fully recyclable with the existing industries. These batteries can be used in distributed renewable generators such as micro wind turbine and large PV plants. These are used for grid support with a voltage requirement up to 600 volts. This is a construction of nickel chloride battery, or it is also, as already I have told to you, it is called zebra cell. So this figure indicates a zebra cell showing the main components of the cell, and the central solid positive electrode consists of nickel conductor surrounded by a mixture of nickel chloride, nickel and liquid electrolyte. The negative electrode constitute a metal cell casing and molten sodium. Both electrodes are separated by a solid ceramic electrolyte, which facilitates the conduction of Na plus ions between the reaction partners, sodium and nickel chloride. It also has the property of simultaneously acting as an insulator for electrons. The cell requires high temperature to liquefy the sodium and ensure the internal resistance is minimized. The maximum temperature is detected by the maximum allowable level of internal cell pressure. During discharging, sodium reacts with nickel chloride to form sodium chloride and nickel. This process is reversed during the charging and it is given by following reaction. So 2Na plus NiCl2, while discharging it is producing 2NaCl plus Ni, and in reverse form 2NaCl plus Ni will give you 2Na plus NiCl2. So this is charging happening. So this way, this is the construction and working of nickel chloride battery or a zebra cell. Thank you very much.